way, if you're gonna use the bar plates, unit of bar, so you must have the put first the make up weight for the bar. Otherwise, if you're if you want to use the kg say centimeter squared, use the make up plate for the kg centimeter squared. Alright, so you wouldn't have an erroneous reading. Right, so we're gonna test the low pressure and the higher pressure. So I am putting multiple plates with a total weight of 10. So basically this a big plate is a 5 bar, and the two plates here are 2 bar each. So 5 plus 4, it's 9, plus the default weight of the make-up weight plus the carrier weight 1, so it's a total of 10. Okay, so when we apply a low pressure, we will expect it become 10. So this is I change the pressure gauge with higher pressure range, 0 to 160 bar. So 10 here, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So it should be here. Okay, so we'll spin it a little. So apply low pressure. So we're gonna expect 10, and weights will start to flow. 5. Now, so start to float now. So as you can see, that at this low pressure indicator, so it is around 10. So there is a little error in the pressure gauge. So that is a pointer error, I think so. Okay. So even at this region, you know, if we vary this pressure at the region of low indicator, but the pressure is the same, so okay, so that is our weight is totally floating. Okay, so 10, this is the low pressure. Now we will apply higher pressure, since this is 10, and the higher pressure, the read indicator, that is times 10, so 10 times 10, it would be 100. I will apply 100 bar with the same weight. Okay, so we're gonna expect that the piston will displace up to the read indicator, and it will indicate the gauge at 100 bar. Okay. By the way, the operation as per here in the instruction, so 0 to 140 bar, let the valve B close, okay, the valve B close, and the valve A open. Okay, for this range, 0 to 140 bar. If you apply more than 140 bar, so it is like this. Close A valve and open valve B. Alright, then apply the pressure for through hand pump. Okay, so since our we're gonna test only 100 bar or even 160 bar, that is still below. Yeah, if we will get up to 160, we'll have to use this instruction. But since we're gonna test only 100 bar, so it is below 140, so this instruction number 2. Alright, so it is closed and valve A is open. Alright, so apply more, a little bit hard. Now almost 100, so see the we can now start the red indicator. See, now it's 100. Yeah, so this is how we'll apply high pressure on a lower weights. Okay, so you just spin it. Now another it's just a tip. You just spin it for a while and look for the pressure. Do not touch the hand, I mean the hand pump. Observe whether the pressure is getting down, and the floating indicator also is reducing or not. If it is reducing and the pressure is getting down, that means there is a leak somewhere. Either could be our connection or somewhere in the system pipes. So that is how we will check the leakage, oil leakage. Yeah. So since this pressure is stable, and there is no changes in the floating indicator. So that means there is no leak. And why we spin it, okay? Why we spin it? It is just to spin, just we are spinning by hand of the weights. So that is to make sure that the weights is free of friction. So since we observe that the weight is, you know, free will, so there is no friction, so we can say that our pressure readout in the pressure gauge is accurate. Okay, so that's it. Then slowly release the pressure, so this spin will stop by itself once it settles on the flange inside. Okay. So that's it, guys. How to doing a calibration using the dead weight tester. All right. Thank you.